Hey guys, welcome back to Beef and Barrel. I'm James.
And I'm Glen. And today, we're going to make the ultimate JD smoked burger. Let's do this.
So let me take you through the ingredients of the ultimate Jack Daniels smoked burger. So first off, we're gonna need Jack Daniels. That's the main part, apart from the burger, of course, which will come to the 25% mince. Gonna add salt and pepper to that. We have an onion that we're gonna, we'll show you how we're cooking that later. Two rashers of bacon, we don't need too much. It's gonna go in with the onions. We're gonna be making a beautiful barbecue sauce using Bullseye's hickory brown sugar sauce. We have a brioche and two lovely slices of mature cheddar. Let's get to cooking. So with our mince, we're just gonna squeeze it all together, give it a good little mix. Make it into a nice ball shape. Gonna season it. And make it into a patty. It's as simple as that. Not much work into this part. Ready for smoking. Right, so we've made the burger. Now it's onto the smoker. First off, you wanna be getting yourself a chimney and making yourself the fire. Once the coals are nice and white, you're gonna tip them into your offset smoker if you have one. Although, if you haven't got a smoker, you can cheat. It won't give you the same sort of flavoring and it will cook a little bit different. However, it does work.
But we don't do that. We don't do that on this channel.
Always doing stuff properly on this channel. So we've got ourselves some oak chunks in there. Burning up. And we want to be getting this to about 400 degrees.
So still a little way to go.
It's only just started going on. So when you are smoking, you want this pipe, this chimney here, to like have a nice bluey grey smoke, like almost transparent. Because you don't want to, if it's too thick, then you're going to over smoke and it will give it a horrible bitter taste. So make sure your fire is always well maintained and well fueled. You need that oxygen going through so the fire can stay alight. With this burger, we've got a caramelized sort of smoked onion, which is going with bacon. It's a sort of a relish. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a whole onion. Just pop it in the fire.
Just pop it straight
just
in
right
it.
There.
Oh, look at you, he's enjoying life right
he's
in
He's loving it.
Like a sunbed shop.
You can smell that onion already.
Oh God, you can't you?
Yeah.
Wow.
So that's gonna cook in its own little shell, go nice and soft in the middle. Fingers crossed. If not, it goes ditch hard. It's barbecuing. What can you say? Right, so the temperature is coming up slightly.
Well, we're getting there.
I think we're ready to put the burger on.
Okay.
So lift this and see what happens is the air flows through the vents into the heat box, then the heat and smoke gets distributed into the main chamber. So we're going to grab our burger. We're just going to put it on.
Oh, lovely.
We're going to close our lid. So now the lid's closed, we're going to add some apple wood.
Okay.
I have some apple chunks here.
Oh, lovely.
And this is going to give it a nice fruity, smoky flavour.
It won't be too dense, too much, and it goes nicely with the oats as well. Just put them in, spread them out, and it will also give us, like, help us with the heat.
How's the onion doing?
The onion's looking nice. That's how we want to see it. It's just baking in its own skin.
Beautiful.
So the wood's in.
Burger's on.
And we can just chill. So now, let's get the onion off. We'll see how that's looking.
How is that onion doing? There's our little friend in there. Look at that.
That looks ready to take off, that.
Oh, look at that.
It is charred. It's going to be charred on the outside.
It's a charred onion.
But that's the skin. We're not going to use that.
But onion's full of water, so it should still be fine.
Yeah, it's going to bake in its own little skin.
Let's go on there with the bacon, the uncooked bacon still. So Glenn's going to get a knife. The temperature is currently up nearly 300 degrees, but he did open it slightly, so the temperature's gone down. But it did get up to 350. So it's a really, really good temperature of cooking there. So what you're going to do, take the skin off now.
Yeah, take that skin off. Oh, can you smell that, James? Can you smell that onion?
Beautiful. Oh, look at that. Look.
Nice and soft.
Okay, so what's the idea with this onion now?
So what we're going to do is we're going to chop up the onion, chop up the bacon. We're going to put it into a
cast iron
skillet. A cast iron pot.
Burnt flavour. Yeah, don't want the burnt. Have a little bit of burnt flavour.
A little bit of burnt, just not the skin. We don't want the skin.
We don't want
on
the
there.
Skin, yeah, the skin will ruin it.
James, would you check on that burger, see how it's looking?
Are we ready? Oh, look at that.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's getting that beautiful smoke.
I'm making a right big zero out of this.
You are.
If this ain't going to make the viewers angry, I don't know what is.
I'll speed it up.
2 hours later.
Okay, so that is now all mixed in there, and now Glenn's going to continue on.
So we're going to get a spoon of butter, put that in. And a tiny bit of oil.
Oil always it adds as like a bit of a lubricant in there and stops the onions and stuff from burning when we're inside. So we're gonna give that a nice juicy mix in there. Like so. Apologise for the wind. The weather is a typical UK weather today. Promised sunshine. And we got delivered with cloudy. Only thing we lack today is a bit of rain. So, where's that going to go?
Go straight into the smoke box because we want that heat.
Oh, and that nice little tray there.
And that's going to sizzle in there nicely.
The butter is going to melt beautifully, I bet. We'll come back shortly.
So we're going to check the burger.
That's a beautiful colour on there.
I think that's looking done.
That is looking done. Right, what we're going to do, put this up here so it's no longer cooking.
Yeah, take it off the heat.
Take it away from the heat, away from the smoke. We're going to focus.
Oh, look at that.
On this.
Right, get that spoon.
Careful when handling this. This is going to be hot. Just going to give it a little stir. So I bet you was wondering, why is this called the Jack Daniels
the ultimate Jack Daniels burger. I'll show you why. So what we're going to do is we're going to finish off cooking this in Jack Daniels. Glug of that.
Two glugs.
Two glugs of that. Depends how big your glug is.
I'd say that's about two tablespoons. Roughly. 2 tablespoons of barbecue just, sauce.
Yeah. With something just, like this, you just got to eye it, make it your own. There's no wrong. There's no wrong.
There's no wrong, there's no right. You do whatever you feel that you need to do.
This is also going to be really smoky as well. It's not quite gone as I had had in my head. And just let that boil away for a little while, take on the flavours.
Yep, we'll be back shortly.
So now the patty is done, we're going to put our slices on. We're going to transfer it into the smoker. Now look at that, didn't that look better?
Wow, that is going to be an amazing relish. No, it's bubbling
that
away nicely there. Let's move the burger away from the direct heat. There we go. Let's get them burgers on. Burger buns.
Just give these a nice little toast.
Couple of minutes and we'll be back.
And we'll be talking.
Okay, so the burger is ready. That's gonna sit there. Just waiting. Oh, the cheese is just beautiful. Relish is ready.
Nice and toasted buns.
Nicely toasted.
Yeah.
Look at that. Perfection. Lovely.
Now let's put
jubbly.
This together. Burger. On. Relish. Ooh, watch your fingers, guys. Because that is hot.
Relish. On. Ooh, dripping.
Let it grip.
Forgot about the cast iron then for a second, didn't you?
Sure did.
Glenn's crying inside at the moment. Oh, it's a messy burger this one, isn't it?
Lid on.
On, lid on.
And we're done. Let's take it to the table and try it. So let's see what this looks like inside. Beautiful. Can you see that nice pink smoke ring around there? Let's try it. I'm excited.
Okay.
You ready?
I'm excited.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Still got juice, look. Look at that.
Mmm.
Sweet.
Mmm.
Mmm. Yeah. You can really get that smoky flavour through there.
Yeah, I really like the relish. The relish is better than I thought it was going to be, because I couldn't picture the flavour at first. And when you was talking about what you wanted to do with the relish,
yeah.
But that barbecue oniony sweetness. You get the sweetness.
You get
don't
the sweetness from the onion.
Considering you didn't use honey JD and used normal JD, you get a surprising sweetness.
And you do taste that JD running through it.
I think
it was beautiful.
I could do with 2 layers of that sauce. One at the bottom.
Double that relish.
Yeah. I think if we were to remake this burger, remake it, I'd put more relish on the bottom, or the bun, more relish on top, and I would probably take the burger off maybe 2 or 3 minutes before we did. Other than that, flavour wise, the seasoning inside's good.
Yeah.
The relish is good.
There is juice in the burger, however, it could be medium.
Juicier.
Medium rare.
I'm getting a right meth here. But
still an amazing burger.
Oh. For what we use, the beef we use, we didn't get the highest quality of beef, you know, just supermarket beef, well seasoned, smoking. That was at least probably smoking for a good 40 minutes, I reckon, wasn't it?
Yeah, around about 40 minutes. See, every smoker is different. You're gonna have different temperatures, different sizes, different burgers. Like, you just gotta keep an eye on it, and that's all you have to do, folks. Wow, yeah. Try it.
Thanks for watching, everybody. If you enjoyed Two Dads Having a Laugh, drinking whiskey and cooking burgers, then don't forget to subscribe to the channel, click the notification bell so you don't miss any more videos. Only one thing left to say, yachidah.